he, beyond a doubt, he's probably one of the most psychopathic individuals that's ever lived. You know, he's up there with someone like Trotsky, who would be a historical psychopath, as would Stalin, Chairman Mao. I can't obviously name people who are still alive that, you know, I would say that Bill Clinton almost certainly is a psychopath, and perhaps his wife, which is quite frightening because it's very rare that psychopaths actually marry each other. In an Irish context, I can only name someone who's dead. You know, this is my personal opinion, but it's probably, everyone probably agrees with it. I'd have to say Liam Lawler had demonstrated as more of the pathology in an individual, you know, while he was alive than I think anyone else in Irish politics I'd actually had witnessed personally. I mean, if you just look at his performance when he was in contempt of court and was going in and out of prison, it was classic psychopathic behavior. He refused to admit that he had done anything wrong, which is one of the hallmarks of a psychopath. A psychopath, if you have him on CCTV, multiple witnesses, his fingerprints, he'll still never, there's something about them they refuse to admit when they've been caught, and they refuse to, it's like they'll go to extraordinary lengths. And hey, that was a classic, you know, that was a classic behavior of a psychopath. He did another thing he did that's a very common thing with psychopaths, is they talk about them, they refer to themselves in the third person. And when he was on television, I remember he was on David McWilliams' show around the time it was really going down for him, and he was caught, Liam Lawler doesn't do this and Liam Lawler doesn't do that, and it's very common for psychopaths to refer to themselves in the third person. He also tries to garnish sympathy, like as if somehow he was a victim, you know, even when he was caught burning, you know, his documents in his backyard. I also heard stories from his constituency that if anything went wrong to a family, he would deliberately show up and try to act like the savior of that family. If their house went on fire or anything, on Christmas Day, he'd bring all the kids' toys over. And he wasn't doing that because he was a great guy. He was doing that because it was what would get him elected. They are absolutely fearless. Are you still there?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah. They're absolutely fearless in that sense. And there was even other things about him. Like they all have high levels of testosterone, and he obviously had very high testosterone from his body shape. It's like, I know it sounds strange, but when you start to really look into the pathology, you can literally walk into a crowded room and walk around a few people, and after 5 minutes talking to them, you actually tell which ones have psychopathic traits. So in an Irish context, he was pretty much classic.
Was he the guy? One of the Barbara Ann, who's on the chat facility, said that Liam Lawler was killed abroad with a lady in his car, but not a prostitute.
Yeah, that was a disgraceful moment in the history of Irish media. She was actually a Russian interpreter. They were driving down a highway somewhere in Moscow, and some people ran out in front of the limo or the taxi, wherever they were on, and the taxi man or the limo driver swerved, and Liam Lawler was killed, and the driver was killed. But this woman, she was very seriously injured. The Irish media, in their Irish mainstream media, in their usual professional capacity, and some newspapers immediately branded a woman as a prostitute, which was absolutely disgraceful. She wasn't. She was just, and they said she was underage. So that's so much for, you know, integrity and mainstream media reporting.
Well,
she wasn't. That she won a packet off them suing them, and good for her.
We know what the media is like over here, and certain TV stations are actually struggling financially at the moment. Now we have on our guest facility, we have Dan and Michelle, and Michelle just want to know who Liam Lawler was. So Liam Lawler was a politician in the 60s and 70s. The other question they had on the chat facility was, what do you mean by his body shape?
All psychopaths have high levels of testosterone, the hormone testosterone, even the female ones. And they tend to have very good upper body strength, and they tend to have a very strong jawline and a low brow ridge. And he had classic of that. And it's the shape of the body, and the women, female psychopaths, now that's not to say they're manly or butch, but they generally have very, very good upper body strength because of the high testosterone. Now that doesn't mean that every single woman who has high testosterone is a psychopath. A lot of women have high testosterone because of, you know, polycystic ovary disorder, which causes the testosterone to grow, but they're normal women, they just have a medical complaint. And it's a way you can read them. There are subtle nuances they have about them that make them, more you become attuned to them. Like that guy I told you about in Wall Street, he had that, and he had tremendous upper body strength, even though he wasn't particularly an athletic kind of guy. I can remember one day he pulled something out of my hand, and it was literally like my arm was going to be torn off. And I'm actually a fairly strong guy. And all the people he had pointed out to me all had this particular body type. I can't explain it. Very good muscle mass up on the top, and Neil Lawler definitely had that. And that's why a lot of them do well in business, because they tend to have good body shape, and they look good in a business suit. And you know, appearances in business are everything, and you see that a lot in a lot of them. Now they're not all tall, they're not all macho, but he had that body shape, and you know, there was other traits as well. There was, you know, this is quite a controversial one, but I actually believe it's true. In many of them, and not all of them, there's something about their eyes. The eyes have a kind of a deadness about them. It's almost like there's no soul or something in there, and Liam Lawler very much had that, and a lot of psychopaths do. Now, not all of them have it, but it's just, and they don't smile properly as well. When they smile, it's fake. It's like a painted-on smile, like a clown. So therefore, that shows up in other ways. They don't have crow's feet on the side of their eyes and things like that.
Okay, let's. I know we can't mention names, but. We've just have a new government in, and we obviously the old government has gone out. So instead of actually mentioning names, let's talk about traits to look for, and then we can just imagine certain politicians that we might have known in the last government and in the new government who might follow them traits.
Okay, traits to look for, very common ones, would be a superficial altruism. Trying too hard to prove how wonderful they are. It's very common with psychopaths. They want everybody to believe they're wonderful and they're really helpful and they're good people. Another trait to look for is no remorse. If any of these people have been elected in the past and maybe have had a criminal problem or maybe a major scandal, either political, financial or personal, and go around like it doesn't matter and it means nothing and seem to have no shame about it and immediately, you know, act like it doesn't matter, that's a trait to look for.
So even if a politician might have run the country into the ground, in their mind, they just haven't done that. They can't see that they've done anything wrong.
No, and they don't care, and they've no shame. They're completely remorseless. They have no conscience about anything like that. It's just business. Hey, I destroyed a country. Whatever. That's literally how they think. They just don't care. They can even make a laughing stock of themselves in front of the whole world, or in front of their whole country by doing something incredibly stupid. And if they're a psychopath, they don't actually care. They don't.
Like if some politician might have been photographed with two girls on either side drunk. I mean,
yeah. If some politician did that and was stupid enough to do that and it went around the world, I would actually be very. I would, and he didn't immediately resign the next morning, considering how bad it made the country look. I would be very, very suspicious about that individual.
And that photo could have went around the world.
And what kind of personality he has inside himself.
And that photo could have went around the world, obviously, and you know, people in other countries could have been talking about a politician that may have got drunk with two girls beside him, and he just didn't give a monkey's. And obviously, you know, I think the victim mentality might have come in there as well on certain politicians who, oh, poor me, I'm only a poor guy from a certain location and, you know, feel so.